Hello everyone. In today's video, we will establish communication between the inbuilt Wi-Fi of the ESP32 and a mobile phone application through the RemoteXY IoT Cloud. This will allow you to monitor and control your project input and output status from anywhere in the world. First, let's see how RemoteXY works. It is made up of two parts, the graphical user interface editor and the Android app. The GUI editor is used to create the mobile app interface and to generate the source code for controlling Arduino and ESP boards and can be accessed at remotexy.com. The Android app connects to the device to monitor and control the device status with the created GUI. The different types of connections are via USB cable for Android, Bluetooth, wired or wireless Ethernet, Wi-Fi access points, and cloud server. Now, set your browser to remotexy.com. You can click on Start Now or Editor to immediately start creating your GUI. But first, click on Sign to create an account. This will allow you to generate a token for the IoT Cloud connection. From here, you can create a new project, open an existing project, and save a project. Let us save this project as ESP32 IoT. Under Configuration Properties, click on the Bluetooth icon. Here, you can select the connection type for your project. I will first use the Wi-Fi access point connection. Then I will select the ESP32 based board from here, under the Choice by Core tab. Under Models, you can select any of these models as required. However, I am utilizing the ESP32 Wi-Fi on chip. Finally, I will be programming the ESP32 with the FLProg IDE. When done, click on Apply to accept the selections. We will only note the port number of the model interface, since the Wi-Fi access point name and port number will be set in FLProg. You can change how the app is viewed by selecting a suitable background color and orientation. A password for accessing the app can be provided here if required. Now, drag and drop the push switch control element from the left-hand side into the app. The push switch will turn on and off an LED. The push switch properties can be adjusted as required. Also, drag in a slider, set the orientation to horizontal, and adjust it as required. The slider will adjust the brightness of an LED. Now, add an LED indicator to show the state of a push button switch connected to the ESP32. Also, add an instrument indicator to show the analog value of a potentiometer with its default properties. A maximum of 5 elements are supported by the free version of the Android app. Click on the horizontal orientation and adjust the control and indicator elements as required. Click on Get Source Code, highlight and copy the code. Create a project in FLProg with the ESP32 selected. Expand the project tree to display the controller Wi-Fi settings. Double-click to enable the access point and type in a network name. Impute a connection password here. Set the IP address to 192.168.1.1. Expand the Ready Services block group and drag in the RemoteXY block. Double-click on the block. Click here to select the built-in Wi-Fi model. Select the access point and impute the port number from RemoteXY. Go to the Input/Output tab and click on Download Description. paste the copied source code from RemoteXY here. Observe that the LED and instrument elements appear under input, while the push switch and slider appear under output. Select the output connection status and click OK. The block now has 2 inputs and 3 outputs. Now, add a digital input to pin D14 with bounce protection and pull-up resistor enabled. Add an analog input to pin D35. Add 2 digital outputs to pin D2 and D13. And then PWM analog output to pin D12. Drag in the digital input and invert its output. Since the LED input of the RemoteXY block requires an integer instead of a boolean, drag in the byte block from the type conversion group. Drag in the analog input and a scale block into the program and connect them to the block instrument input. Double-click on the scale block. Set the upper limit of the input signal to 4095 and the upper limit of the output signal to 100. Connect the onboard LED at pin D2 to the CS output of the block, pin D13 digital output to the push switch, and the analog output to the slider. Then upload the code to the ESP32. Set up the circuit connection as shown, with a push-button switch connected to pin D14 of the ESP32, a potentiometer connected to pin D35, and 2 LEDs connected to pins D12 and 13. Download the RemoteXY app from Google Play Store. Then turn on your mobile phone's Wi-Fi and connect to the ESP32 access points. Open the RemoteXY app and add a new device. Select the Wi-Fi point and the ESP32 access point. Observe that the created GUI on the web editor is now shown on the app, and the onboard LED of the ESP32 is turned on to indicate the remote connection. Touch the push switch to turn on and off the first LED. Drag the slider to the right to increase the intensity of the second LED, and to the left to dim it. Hold down the push button switch to turn on the LED indicator on the app. And then adjust the potentiometer and observe the corresponding response of the instrument value on the app. To monitor and control your devices from anywhere in the world, return to remotexy.com. Click on Wi-Fi access point. Select Cloud Server and apply. Under the model interface, click on My Tokens. Create a new token with the board name. Note the server name, port number, and token. Return to the editor and select the created token. Click on Get Source Code. Highlight and copy the code. In FLProg controller Wi-Fi settings, enable client. Impute your own Wi-Fi network SSID and password, or any other Wi-Fi network with an internet connection. Double-click on the RemoteXY block and select Cloud. Impute the server name, token, and port number. Then click on the Impute Output tab and download description. Paste the source code from the GUI web editor here. Click OK and upload the code to the ESP32. Connect your mobile phone to your home network. Add a new device in the RemoteXY app and select Cloud Server. Impute the cloud server name, port number, and token. Then connect to the cloud server. The GUI is now being displayed as before. Observe a lag in the response time of the control action. This is because of the internet connection through the RemoteXY cloud. I hope this video is useful in your next project. If so, click on the like button and share your thoughts in the comment section. Bye for now.